Welcome to the course on data structures and applications. Abstract data types. Abstract data types defines only the operations but not implementation. This abstract data type, it defines the operation to be performed on data structures but not implementation. Arrays. What is an array? An array, a set of ordered data values or just a group of elements that have a common variable name and are defined separately from one another by a subscript or an index is called an array. That is, it is a set of ordered values or a group of elements that have a common variable name is an array. All elements of an array belong to the same data type. More precisely, we can define an array as a chunk of memory that is used to hold a group of data values of the same data types. Usually, array elements are stored in a contiguous memory location. Take an example. Array. Now, it is an array. It has an address 200, 201, 2, 3, like this. It is a memory location. And it contains some data U, B, F, D, A. Its index starts with a 0, then 1, 2, 3. That is, it is an array representation. Array, abstract data type. Objects, a set of pairs, index and value, where each value of index, there is a value from the set item. Index is a finite order set of one or more dimensions. For example, it's 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1 for one dimension, where 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2 for two dimensions. Methods. For all, A is an array, I is an index, X is an item, J and size are integer. Create. Create an array, J list. This create function returns an array of J dimensions where list is a J tuple whose kth element is the size of the kth dimension. Items are undefined. Retrieve. Retrieve an item A, I. If I is an index, returns the item associated with index value I in array A, else return error. Store is another operation on array passing the parameters A, I, X. If I is an index, return an array that is identical to array A except the new pair IX has been inserted, else return error. Types of arrays. There are two types of arrays, one dimensional array, two or multidimensional array. One dimensional array, it has a single subscript or index in square bracket to denote multiple values of same type is a one-dimensional array. Two or multidimensional array, this comprise two or more subscript or index in separate adjacent square brackets to address multiple values of same type is a two or multidimensional array. Each subscript represent individual data variety or simply an attribute of the data being stored. Declaration of an array. The declaration of one-dimensional array definition specify the array variable name, its data type for array elements and size of the array. The size indicate maximum number of data values the array contain. Example, int marks 10. Int is a data type. Marks is the name of the array and 10 is the size of the maximum elements of type integer. The diagram shows an array of 10 elements on the variable name marks. The general syntax of declaring a single dimension array is data type, array name, size. Example, int n5, where int is the data type, n is the name of the array, and 5 is the size of the array. The n is an array contains 5 integer elements. This shows how to access the elements in an array. n0, where n is the array variable, where 0 is the index of the element to be accessed. Now we are accessing the first element in the array n, is shown here. Array initialization. Array can be initialized in different ways. First one is int n5. The n is an array contains 5 elements of type integer. They are to be initialized in a flower bracket. They are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they are separated by a comma. The another example, float price 2. It contains, the price is an array contains 2 elements. They are to be initialized, if you know, 12.50, 50.25. The one more way of initializing the data, if the number of elements we know, they are to be initialized to a variable without an index. The index is to be measured by counting the number of the elements present in the initialization. Array manipulation. Like any other variable, array variable name with individual elements subscript can be used in arithmetic expression, relational expression, or an assignment, etc. Like other common variable, even we can manipulate the array variable also by using its subscript in arithmetic expression, in relational expression, or in assignment expression. Array manipulation example, number equal to n0, where n is an array with the index 0. It means we are initializing the first element of the array 10 to the variable number. Similarly, we can manipulate the value n3 equal to 98. In the n3, n with the subscript 3 or index 3, we have the element 40. It to be manipulated or changed by assigning a new value at particular subscript of the array. n3 equal to 98. That means the 40 is going to be changed with the 98. Operations. What operation we can do on a single dimensional array? The most important operations that can be performed on a single dimension array are sorting and searching. Sorting in the sense arranging the elements on a single dimension array in the either ascending or the descending order, or searching a particular element in a single dimension array is a searching operation.